All right, with that, here's a quick look at some other stories that we're tracking from across the nation. In a postscript to the massive union cabinet reshuffle, Minister for Minority Affairs Najma Heptullah tendered her resignation and her deputy Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi was given independent charge of the ministry. Former CBI Director Ranjit Sinha has been indicted by a Supreme Court-appointed panel. The panel has held that there was an attempt to influence investigation into the coal allocation scam. Asaduddin Owaisi's party, AIMIM, has come out in support of controversial preacher Zakir Naik. MIM MLA from Aurangabad, Imtiaz Jaleel, said that Naik is a victim of a media trial. Taking forward its task of recovering dues from Sahara, markets regulator SEBI will sell a total of 16 land parcels of the Belegard Group through e-auction today. The reserve price is about 1,900 crore rupees. The Met Department has predicted heavy rains at isolated places of north coastal Andhra Pradesh. Low pressure will bring light to moderate rain at many places in the coastal districts and at isolated places in the Rayalaseema region. China has firmly rejected an international tribunal ruling that quashed its claims to rights in the South China Sea. President Xi Jinping said China's territorial sovereignty and marine rights in the seas would not be affected. Nepal was thrown into a political crisis after the main Maoist party withdrew its support from the ruling coalition and called for the formation of a new government. The threat to topple Prime Minister KP Oli's government looms large. Democrat Bernie Sanders has endorsed former rival Hillary Clinton for president in a show of party unity. He says she was the best candidate to fix the country's problems and beat Republican Donald Trump. The United Nations has called for free movement and protection of civilians fleeing fighting in the South Sudanese capital of Juba. At least 36,000 displaced people are seeking shelter in UN sites and other locations. At least 9 people were killed and 32 wounded when a car packed with explosives was detonated in a district just north of Baghdad. There was no immediate claim of responsibility for the blast in Rashidiya.